Hello everyone, welcome to the YouTube channel Mission Net Physics Exam. And guys, in today's video I am going to discuss the answer of the classical mechanics questions I have provided you for the practice set 2, and all these questions answers step by step we are going to consider in this video, so that if anybody is going to have any doubt in any of those questions, you will get to know about them. Also guys, if everything is clear to all of you, that's very good. You can check your answers here right now, whether you have taken or considered the right steps, or you need to make some changes anywhere. Like, you will get to know about everything exactly after watching this video till the end. Even guys, if your friends are preparing for the exam, you can share this video with them, because some of the questions which we are going to consider, or which I have provided you in your practice set 2 of classical mechanics, because practice set 1 was for atomic and molecular physics, and now this one is gonna be for classical mechanics. Okay, now, so guys, all these were the important questions based on very important concepts of classical mechanics. You all need to know about these questions, the concepts, important formulae, steps, approach, and everything related to the discussion I'm going to do today. So let's just start the discussion with our very first question. But before that, I'm just going to take some time to let you know about the Unacademy Plus subscription and many other important points, and quickly I will start the discussion after that. So guys, if I'm going to talk about the Unacademy Plus subscription, as you all know, there are going to be so many important courses going on Unacademy Plus for your upcoming exam preparation. So if you want to attend the regular live classes of all these important courses for your upcoming exam preparation, then you can take the Unacademy Plus subscription. Also guys, by using and by applying this referral code which is mentioned here, which is Anjali Arora as mentioned here, okay, by using and by applying this referral code, you will get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. So no space in between, spelling should be same, that's how you need to write it and apply it to get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. Also guys, Revise India series is going on, okay, you can join the sessions I am conducting in this series. So like, these are gonna be the important sessions. Also one more thing, in the description of this video you will have the link for my profile on Unacademy. You can check that, okay, and you will be able to get like special classes and many important sessions there. Even if you have missed any of the classes, you can watch their recordings, they are available, okay. So yeah, in the description of this video you can check it, and you will be able to get that link, okay, for my profile. Just you can click on that link and you can open my profile, and you can get to know about many important points from there as well. And if you are new on this channel, that is Mission Net Physics Exam, then you can subscribe this channel by clicking on subscribe button below this video, and after clicking on subscribe you will get a bell icon there. You can click on that too to get the notifications for the new videos I will provide you on this channel, that is Mission Net Physics Exam. Now let me just tell you about the new courses which we are going to have on Unacademy Plus. This is our strategy course, which will be helpful like for all the students, those who are preparing for this recent exam or the next exam. It is going to be helpful for all the students. Then we are going to have the course which is like the quick revision course on physical science, okay, that is even going on, and it will be important and very 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 much helpful for all the students. Then we are going to have the practice course on physical sciences with MCQs and PYQs, it's again very important. And soon preparation course on physics for GATE physics exam is gonna start. So if you will take the Unacademy Plus subscription for CSIR UGC NET category, even you will be able to consider, or you will be able to get this course there, okay. It will be important and very 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 much helpful for all of you, those who are targeting or want to prepare for GATE physics exam. Even guys, by taking the Unacademy Plus subscription, you will be able to attend these courses, okay, for the GATE physics exam, which will help you to prepare for the upcoming GATE physics exam as well, along with the CSIR NET physics exam. The next one is practice course on physics with tips and tricks. It will again start soon. So yeah, if you want to prepare for your upcoming exam with the guidance of all the top educators we are having on Unacademy Plus for your upcoming exam preparation, then you can take the Unacademy Plus subscription. And whenever you are going to take the subscription, you can use and apply the referral code, which is Anjali Arora, as it is mentioned here. Just write it, apply it, and get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. Now let's quickly start a discussion about the questions we are going to discuss in today's session. These are some of the tricky questions, important questions, most important questions, and like all are gonna be the very, very, very important one. So let's start the discussion now. Guys, the first question is, consider two coupled harmonic oscillators of mass M. In each, the Hamiltonian describing the oscillator is this. Okay, this is the Hamiltonian which is going to describe the, like, this oscillator system which is given to us. The eigenvalues of H are given by, okay, like you just need to find the eigenvalues of H. So here they have just provided us the information about N1 and N2 which are present in the option, and options have been given in this way. Now you need to find the eigenvalues of Hamiltonian given to you, and we all know that H psi is equal to what? E psi. So what is the eigenvalue of Hamiltonian? That is energy. That means they are asking you to find the energy. Okay, and for this case, what are the steps you have to take? So if you have already solved it, that's very good. If you have not done that, guys, focus on the steps and get to know about the formulae I'm going to let you know to get a clear idea about it. Clear? So if I'm going to talk about the steps, so first of all, only in this question, what is given to you? Just the Hamiltonian. You want to write the energy for what? Oscillator. What do you need for that? You need the information about omega, that is angular frequency. How you can get that information? So guys, in any of this case, you will start solving the question with the secular equation, which is V minus omega square T is equal to 0. From there, get the value of omega and then just proceed further with the energy formula for the harmonic oscillator, and that's how you'll be able to get the answer. Let me just show you all the steps. See, the Hamiltonian which is given to you, from here you already know Hamiltonian is equal to what? T plus V, which means the kinetic energy plus the potential energy. Okay, next thing, once you are going to know about the potential energy, I've just noted it down here as it is, like as it is mentioned in that expression, only potential energy I have noted down. Now I'm going to simplify it. So here I am going to use the A minus B whole square formula, which will give us A square plus B square plus 2AB. A square means x1 square, x1 square plus x1 square will give you 2x1 square, that's what I have mentioned here. Then x2 square plus 2x2 square will give you 2x2 square, that I have mentioned here. Then minus 2x1 x2, that has been mentioned here again. This is what, this is the potential energy expression. Instead of writing m omega square every time, I'm going to consider a constant, okay, at the place of m omega square completely right now. At the end, I will put the value back. So it's gonna be A. I'm just considering it. Now we will write the matrix for the potential energy. So how we can write it? See, let's say x1 is square. That is like you need to consider the row and the column positions to write the matrix. It will be very easy for you. Like you know, this is first row and first column. So in general, the matrix elements we write as A11, which means first row, first column. Okay. So x1 square along with half. Half also you need to leave here. Done. x1 square and half coefficient will be what? 2 into A. A means m omega square. That you will write at this place. Then first row, second column. Firstly, we mentioned the row number, then second column number. Done. Now, if we are going to talk about this thing A12, which means x1, x2 coefficient. What is that one? That is this. That is minus 2A you will get from here because half is already common. So minus 2A. But the point is the x1, x2 coefficient, like you are writing it at this place, you also have to write it at this place because this is going to be A21. A21 means second row, first column. I'm just showing you the matrix elements, how we show them, how we write them. Okay, next thing. After this, what you need to do, you are going to consider the x2 square coefficient, which means second row, second column coefficient here, which means A22 coefficient, which will be 2A. So that's how it has been mentioned here, and you will mention it. Next point, if I'm going to talk about the kinetic energy, because our secular equation is V minus omega square T, okay, equal to 0, in which we need to write the V and T in the matrix form. So that's what we are considering here. We are firstly writing the matrix form, and I'm explaining you all the steps so that if any student is new, okay, for solving such type of questions and he or she is not having any idea about it, then they will get a clear idea from here and they will be able to solve any such type of question. So I hope it is going to be very much helpful for all of you guys. Next point. From this given Hamiltonian expression, you can easily consider the kinetic energy terms, which are the first two terms. Now, what you will do, you can easily convert them into the generalized velocity terms. Okay, that is, I have discussed the trick based on that in my previous videos I have uploaded on this channel, that is Mission at Physics Exam. If you have not watched all these important videos, you can check out the videos I have uploaded till now. There are going to be so many important videos, and all are gonna be on very important concepts. Okay, so that like if anybody is gonna watch all of them, they are gonna be ready for the exam very well. Clear? If I'm going to talk about the expression, which is P1 square upon 2m plus P2 square upon 2m, you just need to compare it with P square upon 2m, which is general formula for the kinetic energy. And whatever value in place of m you are getting, like you will get here m, you just need to write it by considering half mv square. V means velocity. I'm writing it for x1 and x2. So it will be x1 dot square, x2 dot square. That's how you're just going to write it. And this is the kinetic energy expression. Now what you need to do, you need to write the kinetic energy matrix. How you can write it? Again, in the same way, you need to save half. That means you need to keep it there. It should be there, okay? And then x1 dot coefficient, which you have to write at this place, m. Then again, for the same thing, like second thing, you will have to consider in the same way, x2 dot coefficient, again m, along with half you are taking its coefficient, like keep the half there, x2 dot there, and then what is the coefficient you are getting? It's m. But there is no x1 dot x2 dot term and its coefficient present, so that's why this position 0 0. You got to know about the potential energy and the kinetic energy matrix in this way. Next point, you just need to consider the potential energy matrix, the kinetic energy matrix, also multiply the kinetic energy matrix with omega square. So you will get omega square m here, omega square m here. But since in the question itself omega is given, and this is the formula, like this is a part of the formula, so I'm taking a different symbol. I can take it just like omega dash, omega 1, omega x, anything like that, just a different notation. Okay, this is a part of the formula, not that same omega. Remember, next point. If I'm going to simplify it, I will be able to get this expression after solving and simplifying, v minus omega square t is equal to 0. Once you are going to do this, what you need to do next? Just simplify this part, keep on simplifying, then you will be able to get what? You will be able to get this expression. Here you already know you have considered A is equal to m omega square. Okay, once you are going to put that value, we'll put it later on, but before that, look at this. A square minus B square form, which means A minus B and A plus B, and that's how you are going to get these two terms. Once you have got them, now just need to simplify. 2A minus A will be A minus omega 1 square m. That's how I have just mentioned it here. Then 2A plus A will be 3A minus omega 1 square m is equal to 0. That's how we are just going to mention it. Now, our target was to get the values of omega for the harmonic oscillator. So, just by equating first term with 0, just by equating second term with 0, we will get omega values. Omega 1, actually the notation we have given here, done. Don't worry about this thing that it is for the first case or x1 or x2 corresponding to that. No. It is just a symbol. You can even show it with omega dash. Okay, it's up to you. Once you have got this expression, now you need to put the value of A, which is what? M omega square, which we have considered here. Okay, if you want to keep it M omega square throughout the process, it's up to you. You can keep it like that too. But I think once we have considered it like A, it becomes easy for us to write it again and again and like just to manage the expression and everything. So it's up to you. If you find this method or this process more convenient and comfortable, you can follow this one. If you are more okay with the same expression instead of writing A, you can follow that one too. Now put the value of A here, that is m omega square. Once you are going to put it, you will get omega and root 3 omega, two values. You can say this is corresponding to x1, so you can call it like now omega 1. If I'm now going to take the another symbol, I will say omega 1 dash, omega 2 dash, okay, corresponding to x1 and x2. It's up to you, whatever you want to consider it as omega 1 dash or omega 2 dash, you can. It's not necessary to take it in sequence or something like that. Next thing, we know about the energy of harmonic oscillator. The general formula is n plus half h cut omega. Since here are two coordinates involved, so we are writing it for n1 and n2, okay, two times. And h cut omega, what is the omega? Omega, one omega is just like that omega itself, and the other one is root 3 omega, we are going to put it. And now our answer is going to match with option C, and that is the right answer. Okay, that's how you can get it easily. Clear? I hope all the steps will be clear to all of you now for the question number 1. Here is our question number 2, guys. A dynamical system with two generalized coordinates, q1 and q2, has Lagrangian, L is equal to q1 dot square plus q2 dot square, if p1 and p2 are the corresponding generalized momenta. The Hamiltonian is given by. So here is a trick to solve any such type of question. Lagrangian is given to you, which is q1 dot square plus q2 dot square. As I have told you in the first case, a little bit about that. In the same way, what you need to do, since Lagrangian is what? Lagrangian is a function of generalized coordinate and generalized velocity. Okay. In this case, we are going to consider the kinetic energy as half mv square form. V is the velocity here. So again, I want to write it in that form. So what I have to do, because half is not present, so I will write half at that place. So to write half, I need to multiply and divide by 2. I will be able to get this particular expression, 2q dot square, okay, plus half again 2q2 dot square. Done. If I'm going to compare it with half mv square form, what I will get? M is equal to 2 here, m is equal to 2 here, because for both, like, formula is going to remain same, just the coordinates are different. So m is equal to 2 we are getting. Now what we need to do, since we know Hamiltonian is a function of generalized coordinate and generalized momentum, so in that case the kinetic energy we consider as p square upon 2m. What is m here? 2 we have got for both the cases. So p1 square upon 2m, m is 2, so 2 is a 4, plus p2 square upon 2m, that is again 2, that is 4. So this is going to be the kinetic energy. Or since you can easily consider the potential energy is not given here, only kinetic energy terms are given, so your overall Hamiltonian expression is only this much, which is going to be option A, and that is the right option. Okay, that's how you can solve any such type of question. Wherever you need to do the conversion from Lagrangian to Hamiltonian or Hamiltonian to Lagrangian, this trick works whenever it is possible for you to identify the kinetic energy terms and the potential energy terms separately, then you can use this trick. If I'm going to talk about the next question, let's quickly talk about the third one now. A raindrop falling vertically under gravity gathers moisture from the atmosphere at a rate given by dm by dt is equal to kt square, where m is the instantaneous mass, t is time, k is a constant. The equation of motion of raindrop is m dv by dt plus v dm by dt is equal to mg. If the drop starts falling at t is equal to 0 with 0 initial velocity and initial mass m0, the value has been given here for m0, k, g and all the values given, and the velocity v of the drop after 1 second is, this is what we need to find. Basically, once you are reading this question, you may be feeling like, oh, what are the steps I should take, how I will solve it. So in any such type of questions, when they provide us some of the expressions in the questions, they are going to be quite easy. And in this question itself, we just need to use the given expressions and we can get the answer. Look at this, how we are going to take the steps now. And your main target is to get the velocity. Okay, always remember this thing. Also focus on the given options, then even consider the given expressions and proceed further. It will be easy for you. Then have a look at the steps. It is already given dm by dt is equal to kt square. Dm by dt is equal to kt square is already here. Okay, what do you need to do? Just cross multiply, simplify it. You are going to get integration dm is equal to integration kt square dt. You are just going to integrate because it will give you the value of m. Once you are going to get the value of m in terms of constant, that is c, after integration you are getting this expression. Now you know at time t is equal to 0 what was the initial mass m0, that is 2 gram. So you will just put that value, okay, m0 and at t is equal to 0. It will give you the value of c, which is 2, because t is 0, so this term will be 0 and m is equal to 2 initially and c is equal to 2. This is what you are going to get. Clear? Then m is equal to kt cube upon 3 plus 2. Done. Take the LCM, you will get kt cube plus 6 upon 3. Till this point, what we have done? We have just simplified the given expression. Second thing is, this equation is already given in the question. If you will observe the question, it's already mentioned here. Okay, now what we are going to do, we already know the value of m now, but we are just going to consider this differential equation. This is first order and first degree differential equation. Since our main target or our focus is to get the value of velocity, we are trying to write it in terms of velocity. You already know about the dm by dt value, which is kt square. Just put it here. Once you are going to put that value here, now you need to simplify it. Also guys, one more thing. Here you can see I have just taken m common from this expression, left hand side and right hand side both. After taking it common, you will get 1m in the denominator here because it was not present. Now, you know already, you know the value of m now, which you have found here, that is kt cube plus 6 upon 3. You have just put that value at this place. Now you can see this equation is similar to the linear differential equation form. Okay, where y is v, in this case x is equal to t. And now, what are the steps to get the solution of linear differential equation that I have mentioned here? That is, firstly, you need to find the integrating factor, that is going to be e to the power integration px dx. Px is this, whatever you are having here. Okay, so that is this value in this case. And the next step is y into integrating factor is equal to integration q integrating factor dx plus c1. Okay, that's how you are going to have the solution for the linear differential equation. If I'm going to talk about the steps, like in this way, you need to take the steps to solve it. And here I have just taken those same steps. We have got the integrating factor first after putting the value of p, which is this one. Okay. And then what we are going to do, normally integration has been done here. I have even mentioned the steps, how we are considering the term, how we are integrating further and everything. Then second step, we are using this formula, which I have mentioned in this line. Clear? Then after getting this expression, we are using the boundary condition, that is at t is equal to 0, v is equal to 0 and c1 will be equal to 0 in this way if you are going to consider these values. Next thing, then you are going to get this particular expression after simplification, after integrating this part. This will give you gkt to the power 4 upon 4 plus 6gt, okay? And c1 is already 0, so that's how you are going to get the equation. Now you already know the value of k, g and t. Just put all the values, you will get the value of v, which will be approx 500. You can check the calculation once, okay? And it's gonna be option b if it is 500, which you are getting, okay? And that's how you are going to get the answer for this question. So mainly focus on the concepts, steps, calculation. Please do it on your own as well. It's important part. Okay, next one. Question number 4 is here. A ball bouncing off a rigid floor, okay, is described on a rigid floor, should be there, is described by the potential energy function. Which of the following symmetric diagrams best represents the phase space plot of the ball? So guys, here are the options given to you. Now, in this case, there is going to be a very important point again, okay, and something very interesting too. Let's have a look at this. Since we all know the phase space means the momentum versus x graph, in this case, what is going to happen? Well, since already they have provided you the potential energy expression, you can write the total energy from there, that is going to be h is equal to e is equal to t plus v, which will be p square upon 2m plus mgx. Why p square upon 2m as a kinetic energy expression I have considered? Because we all know Hamiltonian is a function of generalized coordinate and generalized momentum. That's how we are just going to consider this kinetic energy formula most of the times when we consider the Hamiltonian. Next thing, let's simplify it. Once you are going to simplify this part, it will be e minus mgx is equal to p square upon 2m. Okay, second thing. If I am going to consider the next step, after simplifying it, after rearranging the terms from one side to another side, you will get this momentum square expression. Since the phase space means the momentum versus x graph, and from here you are getting it directly, the relation between momentum and x and how they are related to each other. Is that a kind of a straight line equation? No. You can have a look at the type of graphs given to you, okay? Is this a kind of, let's say, a kind of trajectory which will be something like this, or ellipse, like something like this even? No, it's not going to match with any of these forms, but it is a kind of parabola equation. So when it is a kind of parabola equation, which answer will be correct? Option B. sometimes we need to consider the most appropriate answer in the phasor space trajectory based questions, and sometimes you need to consider it as per the equations. Okay, I hope it will be clear to you now that why option B and how you will select it. So basically, as per the type of equation you are getting, you are going to decide which one will be the correct one. Okay, let's talk about the next one. Here is our next question, guys. That is going to be the Lagrangian for a particle of mass m at a position r, okay, moving with a velocity v is given by L is equal to this complete expression of Lagrangian given, where vr is a potential and c is a constant. If pc is the canonical momentum in the suffix c is present there, then it's Hamiltonian you need to find. Okay, the options have been given to you. What are the steps you have to take? Now let's consider that part. Basically, everything is simple in this case. You just need to write the Hamiltonian, that is Hamiltonian and Lagrangian relation. First of all, we have mentioned here, that is summation q dot p minus l. Now guys, here one point you need to be careful about, that is what is q dot and what is p. If you will look at the options, you will find pc is written there. Also in the question it is mentioned, so instead of p you need to write pc. Instead of r, like q dot, you will mention r dot, because you can see r is the coordinate, the general one present here. Then, and that's how you will be able to get the equation, the second line I have mentioned. We have just put the value of l here. After this, what will happen, since we know Hamiltonian is a function of generalized coordinate and generalized momentum, and in this question the coordinate is r and the momentum is pc. Second thing is, that means we have to work to remove this r dot from here. Even the velocity term is equal to what? We can write it as r dot. So for removing that, we are trying to get the value of r dot in terms of momentum and coordinate. Okay, generalized momentum and coordinate. And this is the formula we know, which is about the generalized momentum, which is equal to delta L upon delta r dot. And that's how you are going to get the value of r dot. Clear? Now once you are going to get the value of r dot, what will happen in this case, you will just put this r dot value in this expression here, here in place of velocity, because it is also r dot, and here. So once you are going to put all those values, now what I have done, I have taken this term common, one term, that means with one power it has been taken common. What are the remaining values that I have mentioned here, then simplified. Just after simplification you are getting this expression, which is matching with option B, and that's how you are getting all the answer for all these five questions. So guys, I hope now all the questions will be clear to all of you, and thank you so much for watching this video till the end. And if you are new on this channel, that is Mission Net Physics Exam, you can subscribe this channel by clicking on subscribe button below this video. If you will have any doubt anywhere, you can just mention it. I will try to let you know about that too. Okay, related to the discussion we are doing right now. Also guys, keep on watching the videos I'm going to provide you, because all the videos are going to be very, 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 very important. So don't miss any of the videos. And yeah. If you are new on this channel, then you can subscribe it, you can click on the bell icon. After that, after clicking on subscribe button below this video, it will be helpful for you, the videos which I will provide you. Also, if your friends are preparing for the exam guys, you can share the videos with them too, it will be helpful for them as well. Thank you so much everyone for watching this video till the end. If you want to attend the more regular live classes by all the top educators we are having on Unacademy Plus for your upcoming CSIR Net Physics exam preparation, even for GATE Physics exam preparation, you can take the Unacademy Plus subscription. If you will take the subscription for CSIR UGC Net category, like, you will get all these important courses along with the other courses by all the top educators. So that's how all these things will be helpful for you guys. Also, whenever you are going to take the subscription, you can use and apply the referral code, that is Anjali Arora, as it is mentioned here. By using and by applying this referral code, you will get the 10% discount in the total Unacademy Plus subscription amount. Thank you so much everyone for watching this video till the end. Thank you.